to the 2010 murder case that is still making headlines. Sydney woman Keli Lane was sentenced to 18 years jail after being found guilty of killing her two-day-old daughter, Tegan, in 1996, even though she claimed she gave the baby away to Tegan's father. Now, the child's body has never been found. It's such a baffling case. However, an ABC documentary called Exposed says there's a lot of police evidence that actually wasn't revealed to the defence team, including up to 2,000 phone and listening device recordings. Investigative reporter Caro Meldrum-Hanna has been following the case and she joins us now. It's nice to see you. Thank you. Man, listen, there are so many twists and turns when it comes to
there
this case. Approximately 94% of the total recordings that were that police had were withheld and weren't
handed
over.
That's right.
Why?
So that's the question. Why? Police bugged Keli Lane's house and they tapped her phones. They were trying to obviously get her on tape when she thought no one was listening, confessing to killing the baby or making some sort of an admission that she'd harmed Tegan, but she never made a confession, never made any admission on all these recordings. Now, come the trial, it was actually reported, these were the words in the media, the secret police taps that led the jury to a conviction. They were important, these recordings. 84 were disclosed, tendered as evidence at the trial, and another 8 tapes of the listening device. But we've obtained all these internal police documents that show that is a tiny fraction. So the vast majority haven't seen the light of day. What is on them? Right. Why were they withheld? And there's a duty by the police and the prosecution to hand this material over. There's meant to be, you know, a fair match here between the defence and the prosecution. Everyone should have the same material. But with so many recordings not handed over, the judge is now calling for an investigation. So that's not us, that's him.
You showed the judge in the actual trial, you showed him all this stuff and the look on his face, I mean, he was very adamant that something had gone wrong.
Definitely. He described that figure as extraordinary. How can there be so many not tendered?
So can the judge force the police to release these?
He can't, no. He's also retired now, Anthony Wheeler QC, so he's not on the criminal bench. He retired after this case.
And could any future court case force the police to hand over the tapes?
It's up to the New South Wales Attorney General, firstly.
Right.
He could order an investigation, have a judicial review of the conviction to see if it was safe, to see if it was fair. But right now, New South Wales Police, they've been taken to NCAT, which is a civil administrative tribunal. Yeah. The Innocence Initiative, who are Keli Lane's advocates, are trying to get these tapes released. Police have been refusing to release them. And proceedings are long over. You know, this case is closed.
What do you think, Sam?
Yeah, what do you think? What could possibly... I want to know. You must have a speculation. Are you allowed to speculate?
Well, I'll put it this way. If there was anything damning on them, super incriminating, they would have been tendered. The possibility is that there is something that could exonerate her or they're completely irrelevant. It could be a big mass of missed calls or Keli Lane ordering Pizza Hut for dinner. We know that other irrelevant calls were tendered of her ordering Chinese takeaway, so the relevance argument's a bit thin. We'll only know once they are released.
If there was something that could exonerate her, what would be the reason for withholding that kind of information?
Well, there can't be any reason. There cannot be any good reason. It's against the rules of a trial.
You are in close contact with Keli Lane still. You speak with her quite regularly. What's her reaction been to all of this, to this sort of game-changing...
She still calls us. She calls the office. It's unpredictable. The phone will ring and I totally don't expect it to be her, but it is. She's still maintaining her innocence. She is wondering why there hasn't been further action, why there isn't an investigation into her conviction. Now, of course, she's going to say that. She believes she's guilty. And there's a lot of convicted murderers out there who believe...
She believes
she's not guilty. And there are a lot of murderers out there who believe they're innocent too. So where we are now and the focus of Exposed is there is a way to solve this mystery. And it's through whoever fathered this child.
That's right.
Yes.
Where is he? Come forward.
Exactly.
Show
Whether
us Tegan.
Andrew or someone else, there is a very small amount of men out there who had sexual intercourse with Keli Lane during these weeks. Christmas 95, January 96. Come forward to us.
I know it's always difficult to do sort of counterfactual stuff, but the thing I've always struggled with the Keli Lane stuff is that the alternative set of events, like her own narrative, is so ridiculously implausible. And as you say...
Riddled with lies.
No, it's riddled with lies, riddled with inconsistencies and riddled with just sort of absurdities that she had a baby to a man whose name she can't even properly remember or identify or keeps changing. But you said... It was interesting you said...
Gave
she
birth,
actually
then went to a party.
That's, and all that crazy stuff. It was interesting you said that she... You believe that she believes that she's innocent. You don't believe she's just sort of making it up or lying. You believe that she actually, in her own mind, thinks that she's innocent.
She absolutely believes her narrative. Mm. And she's had every opportunity to shift. Mm. She did shift a little. She retracted the surname in episode 3 of the series.
Norris Norris.
Dropped it and said, you know what? I actually don't know if I'm confident in that anymore. But Andrew is definite. So if she's not going to change, no one can force her to. It's up to her.
I think no matter what you believe, whether she's innocent or whether she's guilty, she really deserved a fair trial. And I believe that the tape should have been handed over in discovery. That should have always have happened. But it's all about this Andrew Morris or Norris coming forward. You're still working on the case. You've got a Facebook page that's set up for tip-offs. So I'm surprised, given all the coverage, this man hasn't come forward yet, if indeed he does exist.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's one way of looking at it. Another way is, one recent lead that we have is that he's not even in the country and that he has a completely new identity, that he's spirited that child away and is living overseas. People say, well, you know, there's been so much publicity about this case, it's so well known. He would have come forward by now. You know, you wouldn't let a woman languish in prison...
For 18 years.
...when you know the child's alive, that's right, and in your custody.
And it's your child and there's nothing, you know, technically the matter with what has occurred.
Or debatable. Could be an illegal act, they're handing over the child. But then again, how far really is this case known? I go interstate to Melbourne. I was there recently a couple of weeks ago and I was sitting at dinner and the whole table had never heard of Keli Lane.
Wow.
They live in Australia, have always been in Australia. Didn't watch the series, didn't see
and
the
And I suppose,
news.
Assuming this story or that theory is true and Andrew Norris or Morris has taken the baby, presumably, to not know what was happening, you'd have to have no contact with Keli Lane whatsoever. So
that's right.
We're talking about basically an out-and-out abduction. So we're assuming that he's not...
And a new identity.
And a new identity. So we're assuming that he's not exactly a law-abiding citizen who says, oh, sorry, this baby I've been raising for the last 18
years. Here I am now.
Yes.
Mm. And I think it's careful too. We're not advocating for Keli Lane's innocence here. We're not saying she should be released from prison.
You don't even know what to believe, do you?
None of us will until if Tegan Lane walks through the door alive
How
or we find her
now?
Body. She'd be 22 years old.
Oh, gosh. Mm. Okay.
22 years of age. She'd have a life of her own if alive. So no one will know until she's found, dead or alive. So we're not advocating for her innocence, Keli Lane's innocence, but what we do want to know is this conviction safe? Was it fair? Mm. Because when we keep discovering these documents and a judge is now saying, hey, hang on, there needs to be an investigation here. This doesn't look right. This is extraordinary.
And that's the judge who heard the case saying that.
That's right. Why not keep asking those questions?
If people think they might know something that could help you, how do they get in contact?
We have an email, exposed@abc.net.au. You can contact us there confidentially. We won't release your information. This is particularly to any fathers, but men who believe they slept with Keli Lane at this point in time. Anyone else with any information, if you saw anything, know anything, get in touch. Let's solve the mystery. And hopefully too, we may see some movement on these tapes. Rule it in or out if there's anything relevant on there. Clear up the murkiness.
Caro, always great talking to you.
Thanks
for having
me.
Keep us informed. Keep us in the loop.
I will.